In this flash tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to create a simple ActionScript 3.0 image gallery. First, import some images into your flash library. Go up to File, Import to Library, and select the images you want to use in the gallery. You will need 4 images. Next, make 3 layers on your flash timeline. The bottom layer will be called Buttons, the middle layer will be called Images, and the top layer will be called Actions. After that, go to the first frame of your buttons layer and drag all of your images out onto the stage. These will be your thumbnails for navigation. Scale these all to the same size. Mine are going to be 125 pixels wide by 83 pixels tall. Be sure to scale all of the thumbnails to the same size so that your gallery looks uniform. Next, spread out your images a little bit on your stage, select them all, and then open up your Align palette by going to Window, Align. Next, click the button to align your images by their bottoms, and then distribute their centers horizontally. Then move your thumbnails to the bottom of your stage to where you would like them to sit. Next, turn each of your thumbnail images into a button. Click on the first one and press F8. First, give it a name of BTN1, and then select Button from the drop-down list. Then continue to your next thumbnail and press F8, and name this one BTN2. Continue through doing this for both BTN3 and BTN4. Now all of your thumbnails should be buttons. After that, you need to give each of these thumbnails an instance name. So click on the first one and type in an instance name of BTN1 in the Properties window. Do this also for BTN2, 3, and 4. All of your buttons should now have instance names. These instance names will help us to target the buttons and give them functionality in the ActionScript. Now we need to copy our buttons across 4 frames. So drag the frame from frame 1 to frame 4 and then back to frame 1. This should create a copy of these buttons over all 4 frames. After that, we are ready to start putting in our large scale images. Make sure to click on your images layer and then drag out your first image onto the first frame. Scale this image to 360 pixels by 240 and position it above your thumbnails. Make note of the position coordinates for the image, as this will need to be the same for the other large images. Mine is at an X of 92 and a Y of 32. Once you have the first image scaled and positioned, you need to go to frame 2 of your images layer, right click, and then go to Insert Blank Keyframe. Now drag out your second image, scale it to the same size, and position it to the same coordinates. I'm going to speed up the footage on doing this for both image 3 and image 4, as the process is just repeated from the first two. It is important to use images that are the same size and positioned in the same way during this step, so that when you click through your gallery, the images do not change size or position from one to the other. Also, make sure that the order of your images corresponds with the order of the thumbnails. Next, we are ready to add in our ActionScript to make the gallery work. Click on the first frame of the Actions layer, and then open up the Actions window by going to Window, Actions. On line 1 of the Actions, type out Stop, open close parenthesis, semicolon. This code will stop the gallery from playing until we click a button. Next, hit Enter a few times and type out BTN1, which is the instance name for our first thumbnail. Then put a period and type Add Event Listener, open parenthesis, mouse event, dot click, because we want to be targeting the click, and then type comma, space, play 1. And then finish it off with a closing parenthesis and a semicolon. Play 1 is our function name and can be anything that you want. Next, we will write the function play 1. Hit enter a few times and write function, space, play 1, open parenthesis, event, colon, mouse event, close parenthesis, colon, void, open curly bracket, and then hit enter a few times and add a closing curly bracket if it hasn't been added for you. In this code block, we define the event as a mouse event, and then we specify void because we are not returning any data. Inside of this function, we need to type out go to and stop, open parenthesis, 1, close parenthesis, semicolon. So now when we click the first thumbnail, called BTN1, the stage will go to and stop at frame 1, which is our first big image. After that, the code for the second, third, and fourth buttons is the exact same. So copy everything below the stop and paste it 3 times. Now you need to change the numbers to correspond with the correct thumbnail and image. So, on this next set, I will change BTN1 to BTN2. Play 1 to play 2. Play 1 to play 2 in the function. And change the frame from 1 to 2. Now continue through doing the exact same process for the code for image 3 and 4. Take your time and make sure that each number is changed to what it should be so that you don't get any errors when you run the final result. So now we can test this by going to Control, Test Movie, and then Test. Now if you typed everything correctly, you should be able to click through your images in the gallery. If you get an error, be sure to double check your instance names and action script. The last thing we are going to do is create a fade animation for our images when they first come into frame. First, click on each large image and convert it to a movie clip. Click the first image, press F8, select movie clip, and give it a name of image 1. Now do this for your other three images to make the names image 2, image 3, and image 4 accordingly. Now go back to your first large image and double click into it. Now drag the first frame to frame 24, release, and drag the frame back to frame 1. This creates a copy of the image across 24 frames. Now right click on these frames and select Create Motion Tween. If a message asks you to convert to a symbol, click Yes. Now move the playhead to the first frame and then click on the image. And then select Alpha from the color effect and drag the slider to 0. After that, move the playhead to frame 24, click on the image, and then drag the alpha to 100. Now you have a simple fade. Next, create a new layer, click on frame 24, right click, and then add a new keyframe. Now open up your actions and type stop open close parenthesis semicolon. This will stop the animation so that it does not replay over and over. Next, click on scene 1 to go back to the original scene. Your image will appear to be gone because now it starts faded out. So now I've paused and added fades to all of the images by following the exact same steps as before. So now we are ready to test the final image gallery. Go to Control, Test Movie, Test. Now you can see that you have a fancy gallery with nice fade transitions. So as always, if you enjoyed this Flash tutorial, be sure to subscribe, rate, comment, and share it with your friends.